The severe and frequent climate-related disasters happening in the Philippines raise the volatility of the country's economic growth. Moody's has a Baa2 stable credit profile on the Philippines. For more on this assessment, we now have on the line Christian de Guzman, the Senior Vice President of Sovereign Risk Group at Moody's Investor Service. Good to have you back on, Christian. Welcome to the program.
Thanks for having me on.
So Moody's in its latest report has a new section regarding ESG, environment, social and governance. So how exactly is the Philippines' exposure to the climate-related disasters putting at risk its economic growth potential?
Sure. Well, before I get into the Philippine-specific details, we just wanted to note that the international investor community, amongst the international investors, there has been this greater demand for assessing credit risks alongside an ESG framework. So it is a much more important consideration. So in that context, we have identified the Philippines' exposure to environmental risks, not necessarily to climate change risks itself, even though that is an offshoot of some of the more severe weather events such as typhoons that we've seen, but also with regards to the natural disaster risk like earthquakes. And indeed, the damages that can result from these natural disasters or these climate shocks can dampen agricultural output, as we've seen over the past couple of years with the El Nino. And it also reflects the relatively large share of the Philippine labor that is dependent on these climate vulnerable sectors such as agriculture. With regards to social considerations, we are highlighting still pervasive levels of poverty, which do constrain some of the value added in terms of the potential for the Philippines to grow even further. And we do note the inequality between the national capital region and the provinces. And lastly, with regards to governance, this is really in line with our very favorable view of the policy framework in the Philippines, both on the fiscal side and the monetary side with the BSP.
Yeah, looking at the report, I mean, Moody's has the view that post-disaster reconstruction and rehabilitation can weigh on a public spending, but wouldn't the extra spending create a multiplier effect and serve as a positive for the broader economy? I mean, more construction work would mean more work or jobs needed, for instance?
Yes, of course. It is a bit of a balancing impact, but I think we also do note that reconstruction is merely offsetting the losses that may have incurred because of such shocks. For example, if a severe flood were to occur in the Calabar zone that impairs the operation of the critical export manufacturing industries there, the reconstruction activities could only serve to partially offset the damage from that disruption.
Another nuance in your report, the drought conditions that have disrupted farm output in recent years, but has Moody's also considered the progressive drop in inflation this year because of the fall in rice prices as a potential positive contribution to the local economy?
Well, indeed, I think this also falls in line with regards to how we see governance in the Philippines. Part of the reason why we have seen inflation fall, rice prices in particular fall, has been because of, firstly, tighter monetary policy by the BSP, which has sufficiently dampened demand so that price pressures can fall accordingly. But also things like the rice tariffication bill, which had liberalized imports, therefore helping to establish a more of an equilibrium between supply and demand. So it's not just environmental risks at play here, but also the government's considerations that led to the fall in inflation.
And there is also the mention of the erosion of the rule of law and corruption, but has there been any material impact to the government's effectiveness in managing the economy and finances?
I think as a ratings agency, we do want to discern the difference between politics and policy. Indeed, the international surveys related to the rule of law and control of corruption perhaps consider perhaps more negatively the Duterte administration's stance on extrajudicial killings and its treatment of opposition politicians. However, I think what's more important from a ratings consideration for us is the policy framework. What are you actually doing with regards to reform? And indeed, the Duterte administration has been very good in terms of raising revenue to fund the infrastructure program, for example, the BSP's ability to contain inflation and maintain a sound financial system. These two things, monetary and fiscal policy effectiveness, do underpin our view on very stable to strong government effectiveness.
So does Moody's intend to keep the country's credit profile where it is at Baa2 stable?
Well, our outlook on the Baa2 rating currently is stable, which connotes that we are happy to stay where we are for the time being, and that the upside risks and the downside risks are currently balanced in our opinion.
And when would be the next review?
We do look at this at each of our credits on a rolling basis. So, whether it's a downside shock or an upside shock, we will consider those accordingly.
So, is the next likely review going to be for a consideration for an upgrade or a downgrade? I mean, where is the bias pointing more towards, and why?
Well, at this point, I had mentioned that there is a balance between upside risks and downside risks. On the upside risks, I would highlight the policies and the outlook for further reforms in the pipeline. We have been monitoring the progress of key legislation in Congress, for example. We do also note that the outperformance of the Philippines, or expected outperformance of the Philippines with regards to economic growth in this environment where global trade is exerting a downward pressure on growth in the Philippines' neighbors, for example. With regards to downside risks, the complementary view there is that things could actually get worse in terms of external demand, and we could see some spillovers into the domestic economy. That's not our baseline view, but there are several channels here other than trade. This could spill over into financing conditions. This could spill over to lower remittances, for example. We do note and want to highlight that the window for reform is closing. We are aware that maybe the window for reform is really only for perhaps another year and a half before we really get into the campaigning for the next election. And there is, of course, a risk of a reversal that we do highlight as a downward trigger, a reversal of some of the positive reforms that we've already seen in the Philippines.
All right. Well, thank you so much for that assessment and the clarity there. Christian de Guzman of Moody's Investor Service, live in Singapore. We'll be right back.